Here's Jordan Jett with the steal and transition and a layup, and he draws the foul. Well, that's just not a smart foul right there.
No, it wasn't, but what you saw with Jordan Jett, he is so quick getting in the passing lanes. You see Short throw the ball to Thomas, but Jett, now he hangs in the air. I'm not sure where the foul was, but, you know, you hang in the air and you hope somebody comes over and gets a little push. Jett hurt his elbow coming down, too.
So they'll go to the line to finish off a three-point play. Steve, from a basketball standpoint, explain to the folks the significance of 37% of the points for St. Louis the last three games coming off turnovers.
Well, it's so important when you're a guard to understand that they're quick and they're fundamental. So you have to, you know, go back door on that play. There's no reason for you to make that pass. When you're in the offense, you got to find a way of beating it. But VCU does the same thing. So it's out. Very good guards turn you over.
Top of course, substituting here. He's bringing in Jermaine Myers off the errant pass by Frazier that went off the bottom of the backboard and out of bounds. Frazier will check out. Now there's Myers, a freshman from Ontario. So St. Louis with the ball, 7-point lead. It's an 8-3 run, or an 8-1 run for the Billikens. Mitchell down low, high low with Redekin in for the first time. Redekin with some traffic gets it off the glass.
Redekin is the kid that had a great game against New Mexico early in the year to upset them. He's coming off the bench. This is a St. Louis team that is very, very deep, as you said earlier. And that's another point in the paint.
Well, 10-3 run after that basket by Jeffrey Short, the freshman from right here in the Bronx at Kennedy High School. And it's a 13-6 ball game.
I like what St. Louis is doing. They're just very, very methodical about. You'll see a hold right here on Redekin. That time, instead of the pick and roll, Redekin split the screen. He slipped the screen, went right to the basket.
So Ryan Rhodes called for his first personal foul. Redekin. We said Redekin, Ellis, and even Barnett. You can point to him and Jordan Jett all coming off the bench for St. Louis. These are guys that have started before in their career. Barnett at Toledo. Here's Ellis for three. No good. Barnett with the board. It'll call foul.
He went right around Short, but he pushed him going through. But you see how confident right now St. Louis is shooting their jump shot because they're getting inside one. These are wide open shots. They're not, you know, shots of the guy in their face. That's what Fulham has to do. They got to go back in the rooms. They got to go deep inside and try to get the ball to Leonard. There's open. You got to get in the ball.
And he certainly has a size advantage on Ellis. His shoulders is way to the hook. Got a touch off the glass. Ellis trying to draw the offensive foul. That's a good no call. Down low by Brent Hampton.
Yeah, he is very strong. Leonard, you have to make sure you give him a look every time because that'll open it up for your shooters like Frazier and Thomas.
Frazier with another rebound. Still scoreless in this ballgame, Frazier is 11 points away from 1,000 for his career. He's held 6 points in the last ballgame for the Rams. Rooms, he could have dribbled, but he didn't. He finished up to the basket and got out to Frazier.
Now, there's no weak side help on Leonard.
There's Frazier, his fallaway jumper, no good. Leonard's there with a cleanup.
Well, there was no weak side. And Frazier drove in the lane. Nobody picked up Leonard. And he was at the foul line extended. Was able to get that rebound lane in.
4 points for Leonard so far. It's a 3-point ball game. So this is a 6-0 run for the Rams. St. Louis working along the perimeter. Leonard sets the screen for Barnett. Lowe's about to check back into the ball game. Here's Ellis, fires again from three. This time it's good as he splashes it down from the sideline.
Ellis looks so much more relaxed than he did earlier in the year. And I think it's because he got his inside game going. He's coming in there and just stroking that three. So is Love.
...16-10 to score. Silver is on top by six. Here's Leonard again, this time from 17. No good. I watched him take a bunch of those shots during shootaround today. Jordan Jett up the floor. He was making a lot of them. Ellis from three to the line up top. No good. He's 1-for-4 from beyond the arc. And now Short to the basket, and he's fouled going up by Jordan Jett. So Fordham has climbed back within reach of the Billikens. They did it mostly because of the inside work of Leonard cleaning up on this missed shot by Frazier. But just as Fordham had pulled it within three, Cody Ellis finally hit his target from beyond the arc.